Hello, Professor Honky Tonk here, and welcome to the first in a series of instructional videos on the Nashville Number System. Today we're going to talk about what the Nashville Number System is, and how it relates to the chord names you might already know, and then we're going to look at the most common chords in country music, and some songs that contain them, and then talk about how those relate to Nashville numbers. So let's get started. Musicians have been using shorthand number systems to indicate chords for centuries. Figured bass symbols were an essential part of Baroque music notation. In traditional music theory systems, Roman numerals are often used to indicate chords within a key. The Nashville number system was developed by Neil Matthews, who was a member of the Jordanaires, a vocal group who backed up musicians such as Elvis in the studio. Studio pedal steel guitarist Lloyd Green offered the following explanation of the Nashville number system. This simple system enables players to simply know the starting key of the tune, and it would always translate without having to rewrite an alphabetical notation if the singer changed keys, thus saving valuable studio time. This system dictates that if a song is in, say, the key of G, that key becomes the one chord, C is the four, D is the five. If the singer changes to the key of D, the mathematical formula is still the same, so long as you know the tonic starting key, which is always one. In his book, Western Swing and Numbers, country western musician Dick Gimbel provides three reasons why the Nashville number system is so advantageous for country western musicians. Number one, it simplifies harmonic memorization because you are always in the same key, the universal key of one. Number two, it makes changing keys, also known as transposing, much easier. And number three, it allows you to see common chord sequences in different songs. If you link your basic cowboy chord shapes to your Nashville numbers in your mind, playing in all 12 keys becomes a pretty simple task on the guitar. Now, it's important to be able to play in all 12 keys when you're a gigging musician because you never know what key a singer is going to ask a song to be played in. For instance, you might be used to the key of G, then you get to the gig and they say, hey, key of B, and you need to, on the fly, in the moment, be able to transpose the song into that key. Now, there are seven Nashville numbers that correspond to the seven notes of the scale. One, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. All right, so let's take a moment to talk about a little more music theory. We're going to talk about diatonic chords. Diatonic chords are the chords that naturally occur if we build chords using the notes within a scale or a key. So if we're in the key of C major scale is all these white notes. If we build a chord off of the first scale degree, off the one, we get one major, C major in this case. We build a chord on the two is minor, so it's D minor in this case. Build a chord on the three, it's minor, E minor. Four is major, F major. Now five can either be major or, more often, five is going to be a dominant seven. We create a seventh chord by just adding another third on top. The dominant seven is kind of a dissonant sound. It sets up a musical tension that wants to resolve. The six chord is going to be minor. The seven chord is going to be diminished. And then we get back to one. So the major diatonic chords are C, F, and G in this key, 1, 4, and 5. 1 is major, 4 is major, 5 is major. The minor chords are 2, 3, and 6 minor. So 2 minor, 3 minor, 6 minor. However, we can substitute a major chord or a dominant chord for the 2, the 3, and the 6. So for instance, instead of having D minor as the 2, we can have D major or D dominant. So that 2 major or 2 dominant is going to be a really dramatic way to set up a movement to the 5. In fact, in music theory, we call it the 5 of the 5. Okay? Same for E, the 3 chord. If I don't want to use a 3 minor, if I want to use something different, I can use that 3 major or 3 dominant to set up a really nice arrival on the 6 chord of A minor in this case. Same for the six chord. If instead of wanting to use six minor, I want to do six major or six dominant. That substitution sets up a real nice arrival on the two, or you can just go straight to another dominant, to another dominant. We see that circle of fifths progression often in Western swing, where there's a dominant chord, then another dominant chord, then another dominant chord. Songs like Right or Wrong come to mind by George Strait and Bob Wills. There are other chords that we'll run into as well. For instance, you'll see four minor sometimes. Often I'll flip from the major to the minor. We'll see a major chord in a lot of shuffles built on a flatted seventh scale degree. So in the key of C would be B flat. But we're going to get into those exceptional things later. This is just an introduction to this concept. Remember, diatonic chords, chords found within a scale. One is the most common chord. It's also referred to as tonic. It feels like home base. When we're there, it feels like we've arrived. It's stable. Five is the second most common chord, and it feels unstable. Another name for five is dominant, and often we use the dominant seventh chord on the five, which is a voicing of the chord that's got a tritone in it, so it's very dissonant. So we have that dissonance in the five chord that wants to resolve to the stability of the one chord, which is probably the most important force in all sorts of music, whether it's country, pop, classical, jazz, etc. The four chord is the third most common chord. Another thing we can call fours, another name for it is subdominant. So the subdominant chord has the feeling of wanting to move to dominant. Okay, so we could call it an example of a predominant chord. A predominant chord wants to go to dominant. So that's why we so often see that progression of 4-5-1 in music. Another predominant chord is 2. 2 is the next most common chord in country music. 2 can either be minor or major. In the next video, we're going to get into the music theory reasons behind that. But for now, just think in country music, 2 major is actually a little more common than 2 minor. So really, you only need 2 chords to write a pretty good song. So we're going to start by examining songs that have just the 1 chord and the 5 chord in them. And there's plenty of examples in the classic country western repertoire of songs that only use 1 and 5. To start with, we're going to look at the Bob Wills classic, Keeper of My Heart. This song's in the key of F. So rather than using the bar chord F, I'm going to put the capo on the 3rd fret and use 2 cowboy chord shapes, the D shape and the A shape, for the 1 and 5 chord respectively. Let's check it out.
If again you were just mine,
next, we're going to check out the Ernest Tubb classic, Waltz Across Texas. It's in the key of A, so the 1 chord is A, and the 5 chord is E or E7. Let's check it out.
We dance together, my world's in disguise. It's a fairyland tale that's come true. And when you look at me, with those stars in your eyes, I could waltz across Texas with you. Waltz across Texas with you in my arms. Waltz across Texas with you. Like a storybook ending, I'm lost in your charm, and I could waltz across Texas with you. Oh, buddy, now.
So now when we add the 4 chord in the mix, the amount of country western songs we can play with the 1, 4, and 5 reaches into the hundreds and even thousands of songs that use just the 1, 4, and 5 chords. Let's look at some examples. First of all, we're going to look at the Hank Thompson classic, The Wild Side of Life. I'm in the key of D here. So D is 1, G is 4, A is 5. Let's check it out.
I didn't know God made honky tonk angels. I might have known you'd never make a wife. You gave up the only one that ever loved you and went back to the wild side.
The next song we'll be checking out is a classic shuffle called Crazy Arms, popularized by Ray Price. I'm playing it in the key of E, but with a capo on the second fret using D chord shapes. So even though I'm in the key of E, I'm using a D chord shape for 1, a G chord shape for 4, and an A chord shape for 5.
Now blue.
So now we're going to look at a couple of songs that utilize the 2 chord. So to start with, we're going to look at Hey Good Lookin' by Hank Williams. This song is in the key of C. So the 2 chord is going to be D major. The 5 chord is going to be G major or G7. And the 1 is C.
Say hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Hey, sweet baby, don't you think maybe we could find us a brand new recipe? I got a hot rod Ford and a $2 bill, and I know a spot right over the hill. There's soda pop and the dancing's free. So if you wanna have fun, come along with me. Say, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me?
Finally, we're gonna check out a song that uses the 2 minor chord. This is The Chair, which was popularized by George Strait. This song's in the key of A, and it would be easy enough to play the chords without a capo. However, if you listen to the original, you'll hear that they are using a capo on the second fret in the rhythm guitar, which voices the chords just a little bit higher using the G shapes rather than the A shapes. So you hear everything's just about 1 chord tone higher in the register by using this capo. So the names of the chords in the key of A, if you're not using a capo, you're thinking A is 1, B minor is 2 minor, and E is 5. But if you're using the capo on 2 and using your G chord shapes, you're going to think of G as 1, A minor as 2 minor, and D as 5. Let's check it out.
Well, excuse me, but I think you got my chair. No, that one's not taken.
All right, so let's wrap this first lesson up. So to kind of recap, the Nashville Number System is a system of musical shorthand, basically, where instead of thinking about chords as letter names, we are thinking about chords as numbers. This allows us to easily transpose a song into any of the 12 major keys on the fly, which is an essential skill for gigging musicians. So in our upcoming videos on the Nashville Number System, we're going to take a look at some of the chords we haven't looked at yet. For instance, the 3 chord, the 6 chord, the sharp 4 diminished, and so on. So I hope you enjoyed this lesson. Please like and subscribe and share the news with your friends if you've got any friends who you think might dig this YouTube channel and blog. So this is Professor Honky Tonk signing off. Remember, the record is the textbook. Happy practicing.